Is it so-called forced labor when it comes to what happens in Xinjiang? Two scholars who call the autonomous region home say following the interviews of some 70 migrant workers from Xinjiang who are now working in China's southern Guangdong province, they hope to report the real rationale behind their decision to move.
They never came to Xinjiang or never asked how these workers feel or how these workers sounds. They came to the conclusion. It's a kind of it's not responsible for the workers. Mm-hmm. Being native of Xinjiang and social science researcher, the report's allegations are serious and shocking. Mm-hmm. We believe that in today's world, any form of forced labor is unacceptable.
I was in Xinjiang when I found out about the Australian Strategy Policy Institute paper. It couldn't be farther from the reality I'm witnessing.
They talked and stayed with people from factories that had been singled out by the Australian study. Based on their findings, the researchers say the migrant workers moved to Guangdong of their own accord in search of better life prospects, a positive experience that would go on to encourage more from their families to relocate. But the experience had been tinged with anxiety from accusations and sanctions from the West.
No, they're worried about that.
Oh.
They're worried, because of this kind of accusations, they may, lose this good job. And they don't know if this happens, how they can get this kind of good job and to earn this salary. And because this job, for a lot of them, this is really important to earn their livings.
Sanctioned companies employing these workers are already suffering. Think about it this way. If the company makes no money, the people whom the West claims to be protecting aren't going to fare better. It's contradictory to what the West movies claim to achieve.
Both say writing these accusations has now become a personal endeavor, as is their future work and research to contribute to their compatriots' pursuit of a better life. Sun Ye, CGTN, Beijing.